I'm Parul. I'm a branding and graphic design specialist. I have been practicing mindfulness through creativity for the last 8 years. I conduct workshops, not just for academic institutions, but also for corporate organizations. Today we are going to explore how we can use paint along with readily available stuff at home to create fun activities for kids. These activities are helpful not just for creative stimulation, but they are also very good to keep them relaxed and calm, to increase their focus, and more than anything, keep them engaged in this period of lockdown.
Our first activity is to make cutouts with paints. You can use acrylic paints or watercolors. Let your child color however he or she wants. It's always better to start with lighter colors though, like yellow or orange, and then move forward to blues, reds, and greens. This exercise is also great to teach color mixing. Once your child is done with the painting, let the sheet to dry. After a while, cut the paper into different shapes. You could ask the child to cut larger chunks of colors while you can refine them into finer shapes. You can make fruits, stars, hearts, balloons, or even flower petals. After cutting all the shapes, compose them on a paper. This is a fun activity for kids, just like a jigsaw puzzle. But in this case, your final composition is as per your wish. Once you both decide what you want to make, you just stick these pieces with Fevicol or glue stick. Finish the sheet with additional elements. In this case, I have drawn balloon strings with pencil, and then I have painted the clouds. Here is my balloon composition inspired from the movie Up. Our next activity is a mini goodie bag. You can use the same colored paper that we had just made and cut out two heart shapes. After you cut those two equal heart shapes, you need to join them from the ends. You can use a Fevi stick or you can use Fevicol to do so. A Fevi stick is better, but I didn't have one right now, so I went ahead with the Fevicol. Once it dries up, you need to punch hole on both sides to put a string. Your goodie bag is good to go. You can use it to put candies or small toys in it. You can also increase its size by making the cutout of a larger sheet. But make sure your satin ribbon is strong enough and tied properly. Now we are going to make a blow paint jungle. For this, you'll need a dropper, a sheet of paper, and your paints. Put a few drops of paint on the sheet of paper and then let your child blow. Make sure the paper is slightly tilted downwards so that the flow is easier. It's a very good exercise for the lungs also, but make sure the child takes enough pauses in between. You can adjust the amount of flow, and you can also adjust the direction by twisting and turning the paper slightly. A variation in this could be by adding a few lighter shades onto a darker one. Like if I add yellow on blue, I get green, and the overall effect is like a gradient, which makes it look really nice. We are now going to do some spray painting. For this, you need an old toothbrush and some newspapers. You could also put to use some cutouts of animals or trees or flowers. Or in this case, I'm using some measuring cups that I got from my medicine bottles. Dip the brush in the paint and let your child spray one color at a time. Once you are done spraying varied colors, you will get something like this kind of an effect. Let it dry and gently remove these caps.
Hey, I hope you liked the video. If you would like to see more ideas, then do check out my Insta page and my website. Thank you.